Welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. I hope for everyone who's watching this video that you are doing great. I'm fine and I'm having a very good time playing around with automation rules. Automation rules is a feature which is released last week by Microsoft and it will make incident response much more easy. Before automation rules were released, there was already a small piece of automation available in Azure Sentinel. When an alert was created, you could trigger a logic app which holds logic to, for example, forward the alert to a incident response system or execute some logic to already block IP address, all that kind of stuff. We now have a new entity in Azure Sentinel called automation rules. And these automation rules basically hold the logic and we can define in the automation rule on what type of incidents we would apply the automation rule. Microsoft made it really easy for us. You no longer need to build logic apps in order to do automation. There is also a basic type of automation available in the automation rules. For example, we could automatically set a severity. We could assign an incident to a certain person. We could add some tags, etc. These are very helpful basic actions that we could execute as part of an automation rule. But let's stop talking. Let's create a good cup of coffee. And after that, I will show you how you get around with automation rules in Azure Sentinel. That was a very nice cup of coffee. Let me now show you how you can work with automation rules and where you can find them. As you can see, I'm already logged into the Azure portal and I have an Azure Sentinel workspace open. If you have a look at the menu, there is a new item called automation. If you click on it, it will bring us to the list of all automation rules that I've created for this environment. Let's click on a automation rule. If you click on the automation rule, it will bring us all the settings that are available for automation rules. Here we have the name of the automation rule, a trigger, which unfortunately we cannot change, the conditions, and if these conditions are met, we can execute certain actions. We can make sure that the rule is only available in a certain time span. After this time span, the rule will automatically get disabled. And we can set the order of an automation rule. Multiple automation rules can get applied to a single incident. So it's very helpful to set the order over here. If you have a look at conditions over here, we can filter on which incidents this automation rule will get applied. In this case, the automation rule will get applied on all incidents that I'm creating in this Azure Sentinel workspace. But we can narrow this down to incidents with a certain name. And the name is equals to the analytics rule. We can add other filters, for example, the description, severity, we can filter on tactics, all kind of stuff. If you have a look at actions, you'll see a logic app over here, which is getting executed once this automation rule is applied. But there are multiple options over here. We could also have an action that will change the status of the incident or change the severity of the incident, assign an owner or add tags. If we now go over to analytics rules and open my analytic rule, you could also see there what automation rules are applied to this specific analytic rule. In this case, you see that only the send to Slack automation rule is getting applied here. So let me now show you how you can create a very basic automation rule, which will set the severity of our incident to informational. If we have a look at my Azure Sentinel workspace over here, you'll see that I have a very simple analytics rule, which will alert me when something in my Azure environment changes. Here we have the KQL query that's being the base of this analytics rule. It's very basic and it potentially can generate a lot of noise. So my security team is ignoring informationals. So what I want to do in this case is create an automation rule which will change the severity of this of incidents based on this analytics rule to informational. So if I go over to the automation part of Azure Sentinel, I click on create a new rule. I give it the name set severity to info. I want this to get applied on the Azure updated analytics rule. I will add an action in called change severity, and I will set it to informational. I want this rule to be available for always, so I will not set a expiration date. And as you can see, it will get order 3. If I click on apply, my automation rule is created. And once a new incident is coming around, it will automatically set the severity for me to informational. So let me now show you a more advanced type of automation rule. If we go to automation and click on the send to Slack automation rule, you'll see that I make use of a logic app as part of the actions. So when this automation rule gets triggered, it will also trigger this logic app over here once the conditions above here are met. Let me give you a quick glance on the logic app. It's a quite simple one, I can tell you. Here it is. Let's click on edit. What it only does, it will make use of the when Azure Sentinel incident creation rule was triggered activity. And it will then post a message to my Slack channel. What's interesting to mention over here, that is for this logic app, I make use of a service principle. Normally the logic app asks you to log in with your normal credentials. What I did is connected with a service principle, which is a app registration. I will show you that in a minute. So it is not tied to a user account. So if you have a look at the Slack part over here, it's very easy. I can select my Slack channel and the text of the message that I will post. And if I want to add some more data in here, for example, the description of my incident, I can easily add that. Description, and then here in the variables model, I can filter on description, and I will get the incident description in there. Let's click on save, and now the incident description will also be part of my my Slack message. If we have a look at Slack over here, you'll see all the messages that have been posted with the deep link. which is quite helpful for our security engineers as they don't have to manually navigate to the incident. Here, as you can see, they will get directly into the incident. This is very helpful and easy for them. So this is how a Logic app works. Let me show you one thing that I did in order to get this working. If I go over to my subscription and go to the access control panel, click on role assignments, I created, as I said earlier, a app registration which is getting used by my Logic app. And on that app registration, I gave it special permissions. I gave it Azure Sentinel Automation Contributor permissions. So with this permissions, it can interact with Azure Sentinel and can only do that. So that's quite safe. So this is basically how a more advanced scenario of automation rules can work. So in this video, we explored the automation rules in Azure Sentinel. They are very helpful and make incident response much more scalable, as we can apply a single automation rule to multiple types of incident. I really liked it. We also explored two scenarios in this vlog. You saw how you could create a very basic automation rule, which allows you to change the severity for incidents on which the automation rule is applicable. But we also saw a more advanced automation rule where we use a Logic app to forward our incident to Slack with a deep link, so our incident handlers can click on that link and directly will get forwarded to the Azure Sentinel incident page. So I hope you learned something from this vlog. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, please hit the thumbs up button. Also subscribe to this channel and hit the bell button so you will get a notification when I post a new vlog. And with that, I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.